Hi everyone, it's Jake. Last video, we took the first steps towards analysing the DNA of the bacteria that we have isolated. We did this using the PCR technique, which helped us to make more copies of a particular section of the bacteria's DNA code. This section codes for a gene which varies between different types of bacteria. So, if we analyse the gene, we can identify which type of bacteria it is. But before that, in order to check that the PCR has been successful, we need to see how big the pieces of DNA are, how many jelly beans or chemical units are in the section that we've copied. This will help us to see if we've managed to amplify the right gene or accidentally amplified another section of DNA. To do this, we need to run something called gel electrophoresis. Now this sounds complicated, but the key thing to understanding this process is that as a molecule, DNA has a negative charge. So, when we apply an electric current, the DNA will move from the negative electrode to the positive electrode. Smaller pieces of DNA will move faster, so we can separate the DNA based on its size. Our sample is loaded into a special type of gel. We've also added a loading guide so that we can see when our sample has reached the bottom. Now we just have to wait 50 minutes for the process to complete. What I have here is a picture of our gel taken under UV light. The gel that we put in the machine contains a special chemical that binds to DNA and glows under UV light, which allows us to see it. Here you can see a bright band in a lane where we added the bacterial DNA from the PCR. The band tells us how far the fragments have travelled, but how can we tell what size they are? Well, in this first lane, we run a special mixture of DNA that contains the fragments of specific known sizes. This means this first lane acts like a scale on a graph. If we compare the distances of our sample fragments to this scale, we can estimate the size of our PCR product. In the picture, the DNA from our PCR product seems to be around 500 base pairs, which is about the size we would expect for the gene we wanted to copy. So, it looks like we've amplified the correct section of DNA from our isolated bacteria. In the next video, we're going to be sequencing the gene and reading the code so we can work out which type of bacteria it comes from.